Uterine cancer and endometrial cancer are interchangeable. A lot of women think that your pap smear will test for uterine cancer, and this is not true. Your pap smear tests for cervical cancer, and it's very important that you do your annual exams, but that's only looking at cervical cancer. Your uterus and your cervix are connected, but those are two different cancers. The most common reason that women come in and we decide to work them up for uterine cancer is bleeding, mainly postmenopausal bleeding. It doesn't matter if it's just a little or if it's a lot, you need to go to your gynecologist.
Your OBGYN will probably want to perform an ultrasound on you and look at your uterus and the lining inside your uterus. Your OBGYN will probably want to perform an endometrial biopsy, and that is where we get the tissue from up inside the uterus to detect if there's any abnormality, which could be endometrial cancer or a precursor cells to endometrial cancer.
The good thing about uterine cancer is that if you catch it early enough, you can get rid of it with just a hysterectomy. I can't stress enough how important it is, if you have bleeding after you've stopped having periods, to go in and let your gynecologist take a look. Do an exam, do an ultrasound, because it is one of the simplest things to fix if we catch it in its early stages.
Number one risk factor in endometrial cancer is unopposed estrogen. Estrogen likes to live in our fat. So dieting, exercising, and weight loss will be one of your first preventative measures against endometrial cancer.